Hi guys, ICstation.com sent me this buck boost converter, and just by looking at the inductor winding and the heatsink, we can guess that this can handle decent amount of power. Let's see what the product page says about the specs. 5 to 32 volts input, 1.25 to 20 volt output at maximum of 5 amps. And the efficiency should be as high as 96%. That's something I will test in this video, so nice specs at least on paper. Many buck boost modules have two inductors because they have boost converter followed by buck converter, something like this. This module that I'm testing today has only one inductor because it uses more sophisticated synchronous buck boost circuit with four switches, which are low resistance MOSFETs. By operating these switches certain way, this circuit can be a buck or boost converter depending on what is needed to achieve desired output voltage. This single inductor circuit has higher efficiency than non-synchronous boost and buck converters that are connected in series. This is my test setup that I'm going to use for the efficiency test. Bench power supply connected to converter's input. Voltage and current readings have been tested to be accurate enough for this kind of tests. Same goes for voltage and current readings of this adjustable dummy load. When this dummy load is running, measured voltage is shown on the top display when this top LED is on. Current is shown in this bottom display. Here's the first test. 500 milliamp load and output is set to 12.14 volts. Input is 18 volts at 365 milliamps. That's around 92% efficiency. I repeated this with 4 different input voltages and 4 different output voltages, all at 500 milliamp load. To cut out the boring, repetitive parts of this video, here are the results. Pretty impressive in my opinion. Small errors are of course possible, but still, I'm very pleased with these results. Losses are highest when this converter is used as a buck converter, with high difference between input and output. But even then, losses are relatively small. In the last test, I set the load current to 5 amps, which is maximum rated output current. And I chose input and output voltages, which had the lowest efficiency in previous test. I let this run for 20 or so minutes. After that time, the output voltage didn't decrease and nothing got too hot. Sure, the heatsink and some of the components are warm, but they are not too hot to touch. Based on the tests I've done, this buck boost converter lives up to my expectations. I don't ask much from my viewers, but two things that I would appreciate are you subscribing to my channel and liking this video if you haven't already. See you in next video. Thanks. Bye.